SoundForge Audio Studio is a great piece of audio recording software. In this SoundForge tutorial, I'm going to show you how to record this,
getting a great rock
through this,
finding a great sounding bass.
That's right, I'm looking at how to record internal audio on PC. Welcome to Simple Green Tech. I'm Radio Zane, and on this channel, I do audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. And like I said earlier, today's SoundForge tutorial is looking at how to record internal audio on PC. And I'm doing this using SoundForge Audio Studio 13. Now, what I mean by internal audio is the audio that's playing through your computer. So it could be like this YouTube video, for example. If you wanted to record me talking right now, you could do that through SoundForge Audio Studio 13. Now, this sounds like it should be simple. And it is, it just takes a little bit of setting up. So let's get to it. Before you open SoundForge, you first want to make sure that your Windows sound settings are set up correctly. Now right-click on the little speaker icon down here in the Windows taskbar, and then click on Sounds. Now go to the Recording tab, and if you see Stereo Mix in here as an option, right-click on it, and set it as the default device. If you don't see it here, right-click on any of the options that you do see, and then you want to click on Show Disabled Devices. And now you'll see Stereo Mix here. Right-click on that, and you might have to click on Enable, so click that. Then right-click on it again, and set it as default device. All right, with that done, now you can click on Playback. You want to make sure that speakers is set as your default device here. So right click on it and set it as default device. You can now click OK to close out of this, and we can now set up SoundForge Audio Studio 13. All right, with SoundForge Audio Studio 13 open, you need to go up to Options, Preferences. Then you want to click on the Audio tab if it's not already clicked on. Go over to your Record tab, and your audio device type, you want it set to Windows Classic Wave Driver. So if it's not set as that, click here and change it to that. And then down here in channel 1 and 2, you want it to Stereo Mix Left and Stereo Mix Right. If these aren't selected, you can easily just click in here, find Stereo Mix Left and Right in this list, click on them. And that's it. Now, if you don't see these options, you may need to click down on the Advanced tab, and then you'll see as one of your inputs, the Stereo Mix. Then click on that, click OK, come back here, and then you can choose Stereo Mix Left and Stereo Mix Right. Once that's set up, click on your playback driver, and you want to make sure that channel 1 and channel 2 in playback are set to speakers left and speakers right. Yours might be called something slightly different than this, but it is your system speakers that you want to be recording. So whatever it's called on your system, make sure you click on that. And once you're ready, you can click OK here to get out of it. And before we actually start recording our internal audio, there's one more step we need to make. So you go up to View, click on Record Options, and if your monitor is set to On or Auto, click it onto Off, and then close out of this. We're now ready to record internal audio into SoundForge Audio Studio 13. So let's give it a test. Okay, so I have one of my videos loaded up here. I'm going to start playing it, and then I'm going to go into SoundForge and record it. So here's play.
Getting a great rock bass sound without having a bass guitar can be tricky. And finding a great sounding bass VST plugin isn't the easiest thing to do.
And that's it. Click up here to see my SoundForge Audio Studio playlist, or click down here to see what YouTube recommends you watch next. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos from me. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane. And we'll talk soon.